اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. طاهر طاهر أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نويت الأربعين نويت الاعتكاف نويت الخلوة نويت العزلة نويت الرياضة نويت السلوك لله تعالى العظيم في هذا المسجد يشتغل. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد حتى يرضى سيدنا محمد. ما شاء الله. Look these phones. The highest quality phone. Ego phone, yeah. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نويت الأربعين نويت الاعتكاف نويت الخلوة نويت العزلة نويت الرياضة نويت السلوك لله تعالى العظيم في هذا المسجد. الله أكبر. This small instrument, zoom here. Look, there is a microphone, picture of a microphone. See it? And it's very tiny. And it's taping and registering everything. Taking picture, taking sound, taking everything and keeping it whenever you need it. This is dunya innovation. Allah creation is more and more advanced. Why there is competition? Allah creation is more and more able to keep, get this knowledge and keep them. And whenever we need them, you can get them up, can get them out. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without ammunition cannot leave His servant to the hand of shaitan. He gave us ammunition. And He said, use it. And how to use it? By what? Ibadah. Allah said in Holy Quran, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون. ما أريد منهم من رزق وما أريد أن يطعمون. إن الله هو الرزاق ذو القوة المتين.
I don't want anything from you. I created you, ins and jinn. That's why there is jinn. Might be loads of jinn now sitting here. If you can see, you see. If we can see, we see. If we cannot see, but they are. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسِ. I did not create jinn and ins. Means jinn are between us. And they are sitting like what we are sitting, listening. I don't know if they are sitting here now and listening, but for sure, mu'min jinn will listen to any place where it is mentioned Allah's name. So they are everywhere and ins are everywhere. So what Allah wants from them? To worship. That's our duty. He didn't say, I want you to work in dunya. He said, I created you to worship. مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقٍ وَلَا يُطْعِمُونَ. I don't want from them any rizq to provide themselves. I will provide them. But people today, all of us, we are greedy. We want too much. Okay, you want too much, struggle. Some people, I gave them too much because it's my will. No one can object. Some people, I gave them little bit. It's my will, no one can object. It is said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given His awliya without running, without struggling, because they struggled enough. And Allah gave them for the benefit of His servants to help. And one of them is that ashukur, to thank Him, and awliyaullah are thanking Him. We forget. We thank Him when someone is sick, and we say, oh, he's sick, I'll pray for him. You pray, and he becomes Allah. He become okay. Then you say, oh Ya Rabbi, thank you. At that time he remembers, or she remembers. And Allah gave immediately a sign, an incident, a symbol to confirm what we are saying. Someone tripped. He said, stripped. it's a little difference. Only increase S. Someone tripped already speaking. Allah doesn't want anything from us. He wants us to remember Him. وَبِالشُّكْرِ تَدُومُ النَّعْمُ. By thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, more and more, that Allah will keep provisions on you. And His provisions are too many for His awliya. Even a plate, they cannot offer to you anything except a plate, and they share it like 10-15 people, and they eat from it directly with their hands, not like today. Everyone wants a plate, wasting money. Before, no, all of them the same, one plate here, and everyone extend his hand, like in Bangladesh. How you serve food? Everyone one plate? Forget nowadays. One plate for 10-15 people. Everyone take his share. But the wisdom is that plate never ends. There is barakah in it. It's not only feed 10-15 people, it keeps feeding. That's barakah that Allah gives to awliya Allah's food. food, no one will go hungry. Even one plate, everyone eats from it. Because they are always thanking Allah, even on the food they are thanking that is in front of them. Allah keep giving without you seeing. Some of them, Allah put the barakah in the food in order that the food will become more and more. That is Awliyaullah, that is the sign of Aqtab, Awliya. That is the sign of Budala, Nujaba, Nukaba, Autad, Akhyar, different group of Awliya. Some of them, some people come, are in need for money. Some of them Allah put by His wish, there are angels on this, they put under His prayer rug whatever he needs. And if he needs something, he knows that he doesn't have, he pull his hand under the prayer rug, get and give. You saw that in your life? Shaykh Hassan? So someone take from under his carpet money and give? We saw that? No. It's rare. It's only for certain awliya. I saw it. Not I, but iPhone. One time in Damascus, in the 80s, there was someone who has to pay money to an official institution, government loan. He has to pay that, and it is very, very important to pay, or he go to jail. So, and it is a big amount of money. I witnessed that. So he collected the money, put it in a suit, a bag, and it was above 1 million. And they don't deal there with checks, cash. Carrying and going to pay, and there was a ghara jawiyya, airstrike, four aeroplanes coming from Israel on Damascus, throwing bombs. That car blown up, the money gone, that person was saved. All money burned, disappeared. Government doesn't care, disappear, not disappear, you have to pay. Where to go to get money? He heard that there is in the mountain someone who is a wali. Go to him. So he went to see that wali. That wali hosted him and he came with like 3-4 cars, Mercedes cars, security, everything, going up all the mountain to come to that wali's house. The whole mountain, people living there, running to see who's that. Never they saw these car, black cars, tinted glasses, and people with security and so on. Who are these people? And that man went up, came out of the car, going to that wali. See, this from Karamatul Awliya, from miracles of saints. Stepped down, he went directly to that tiny, miny, what's that song? Bashu? What?
Itsy bitsy spider.
Tiny, miny house. Very umbaraka. Might be if you shake one of these pillars, wood pillars, the house goes into sajda. Came in, and that wali welcomed him. Came and sat there, didn't talk. Then he said, "Oh my Sheikh, pray for me." He said, "I'm praying for you before you came here. You don't recall that you were being saved? I was there." Immediately that one kissed the Sheikh's hand. He was from Ahlul Bayt, that person. Very well known. It was war in the streets. I was sitting there. He said, "Ya Sayyidi, I'm in big problem. I have to deliver that money to this to this institution, and it's gone. I need your help." And he looked at the Sheikh and he said, "At least in order that I can postpone that until you help me, I'm ready to take this one to go down with me and speak with the officials to delay that money is coming, to delay the postpone the payment." And he looked at me. I said, "How we can go and all these bombardments coming?" He said, "Don't worry, I get a tank here and they take you by tank down and you speak with them." And at that time that wali said, "No need, we have people to speak to them. Come tomorrow." He left. I said to that wali, who is Mawlana Sheikh Nazim, may Allah give him long life, "What Mawlana you are doing? You are promising him to come tomorrow. From where you will get the money?" He said, "Don't worry. As usual, don't worry. Allah Kareem. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقٍ وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَنْ يُطْعِمُونَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ." "I don't want from you except worshipness. I don't want from you rizq or to provide rizq. I am the Razzaq to provide everyone." Said, "Don't worry." "What don't worry?" have to worry. This is 30 years ago. Like today, people, they worry too much. Still we worry. I was at that time in the early 30s. Because these people are not normal people. They are Ask Italy, this type of people. Ask Italy. Why? Italy, what there is in Italy? Not pizza. So came next day, and with him lot of food coming, bringing big pots, might be 40, 50 big tray of rice with meat, like, you know, on a truck coming. Mawlana called the whole high district, street, come and eat. All in line. Eating that food with Mawlana's barakah never finished. They prayed Zuhr with Mawlana, prayed Asr. They want to go. And Mawlana pulled his hands under the carpet and brought a piece of paper. I'm looking. The man was shocked. What you are giving? These people, they need cash. He said, take this piece of paper. Go give it to them. He said, yes, no Sayyidi, nothing. Don't talk. When Awliyaullah are serious, not like today. Sometime, Mawlana, may Allah give him long life, he's serious, cannot say anything. Don't talk, don't tell me. You take, go. Finish. The man took the paper. I was curious to see what is in the paper. It's a paper like that. Like a check, but and written on it, take this paper and deposit it. Because usually they accept paper to deposit. The man took the paper and went. Next day, coming to Mawlana Sheikh, kissing his hand and feet. Why? What happened? He said, Ya Sayyidi, they took the paper. After 3-4 days, the money in his account being paid to these people. How this happened? You cannot imagine it. I saw that. I witnessed that. So Awliyaullah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, provide them for the ummah. That one, because from Ahlul Bayt, and is his khair, his generosity, was so many homes, poor families from Ahlul Bayt were living out of his generosity. Awliyaullah, they don't turn someone from the family of Prophet down. They help. And this is a karama, and they don't show karama. Very rare. That's why it is here mentioned. وهذا مشهد من مشاهد الأولياء ومنها تيسير دنانير ودراهم أو كليهما أو غير ذلك مما تدعو إليه الحاجة وبعضهم لا ينتصب على سجادته لذكر وصلاة في خلوته إلا وخلق الله على سجادته وتحتها دراهم. that because of these people, they are on the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will not put them down. He will create under their carpets darahim, money, to help the needy ones. So we have to learn that dunya struggle, yes, you want lot of money, okay, struggle, no problem. Work hard, you get. But if you are if you want to be normal life, you don't need to struggle, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make dunya slave for you. Today anyone goes to visit Mawlana Shaykh, may Allah give him long life, he will never go without anything in his hand. And Mawlana sitting on his couch, not working, not doing anything. No? You go there, he opened the drawer, Allahu Akbar, Mawlana, what is this? Always the drawer is full. You didn't see the drawer where he is sitting? Where is the drawer? By his feet, near his legs. Anyone comes, open the drawer, go, take. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provide for them because He knows they provide the Ummah. So those people, they want the fruit, they don't want only the shell. So for them, Sharia is important, Hakika is important. Means Zahir is important, Batin is important. And they have to go side by side, parallel to each other. You cannot take one and leave the other, then the balance is not, the scale is not in balance. You have to take both of them serious, and they move together. That's why Sayyidina Abdul Qadir Jilani said, Isma' kalami, listen to what I am telling you. They are strong, they are not like playing with their murids. He is ordering, listen to what I am saying. If you have sincerity in your heart, as we explained yesterday, and what is on your tongue is what is you show of action, not what is on your tongue something and on your heart something else. No. What both of them, they balance each other, that will yukhmid nara tab'ik. It would put off the fire of your ego, because the ego is how he's been raised from childhood. So a wali also is being raised in a different way from Allah made his father and mother to raise him in a straight way. But they have pure parents that they raise their children. It depends on how you raise your child and you reflect on him or on her, good characters or bad characters. That's why we say, طفل النفس المزمومة. Our ego is like a child that has been raised on bad characters, that it is reflected from father and mother. So that's what we call taba. You will be like imprint character from the character of the mother and the father and the environment around you. If the environment is a shaitanic environment, what is the child going to come? Going to be the same. So he said, if you, what is on your tongue is the same of what is on your heart, that will put off the fire of your character, of your ego. وَيَكْسِرْ شَوْكَةَ نَفْسِكَ, and it will break the arrogance of yourself. Because you think yourself, you are so important. Everyone thinks himself important. You don't want anyone to say to you anything.